What's it going to do? Let's have a look. One end goes in here, the other end in here, and check that out. Hi guys, today I have a video on a device which I found whilst browsing Amazon. It's this, the Treedix USB Cable Tester. I think every self-respectable techie geek should have in their toolbox. It's very small, as you can see, it fits in the palm of my hand, and it only costs $16. I'll leave a link in the description below. Anyway, let's have a look at the back. As you can see here, multifunctional, supports multiple types of interfaces, and there's the type of USB cables it can detect or test. And it supports two power supplies. It's got a CR2032 button battery, or you can use an external power supply with a range of 3 volts to 12 volts. Okay, it's time to open this up. Small screwdriver. And we have a little Perspex case. I bought the case version, by the way, for an extra dollar. We have the manual. So, it's interesting. Pause it if you want to have a closer look at this manual. And on the back, it's all in German. Right, let's open it up. Okay, let's have a closer look at the device itself. Here we have the on-off button. Nothing happens because there's no connection going from one end to the other end. Right, here on the side we have a USB A 3.0 port, and then we've got a USB A port again. This is for the USB 2.0, and then we've got a USB-C port here, and then the other side, these basically connect to any of these here, and then we have the type B USB 3.0 port, and then we've got a type C port here, and then here we have a I believe it's a micro B type connector. This is a USB 3.0 standard, and then we have the USB 2.0 mini connector. These were used on the PlayStation controllers and things like that. Then we have a lightning port, as seen on many Apple devices, and then we have the micro USB 2.0 port, the annoying micro connector. And over here we have another means to power it with this connector here. You can use either the 2032 battery or this, whatever you choose. Let's have a look on the back. And at the back we have some pin layouts of the connectors and stuff like that, which is interesting. It's also in the manual as well. Right. Oh, and there's a little warning saying don't connect to device. Basically, that's warning you not to have one of these ends plugged into, say, a computer or a console or anything like that. You're only meant to connect it from one end to the other end with itself, or you risk damaging it. Let me get some cables and I'll do some testing. Right, I've got some cables now, so let's have a test and see how it performs. This cable is basically this standard cable. It's got a little switch on it. I don't expect much from this cable, and there's no markings on it, so one end goes into here to the USB 2.0. And the other end is a micro USB. And the most basic connection possible. You got the ground and you got the VBUS, which is just power basically. This cable cannot pass data at all. And let's have a test of the switch. As you can see, it cuts the VBUS, which is probably the 5 volts, when it's connected up. And it seems to be functioning okay. This side doesn't light up at all. On to the next cable. Next one, I have this cable. It's the Logitech one. It came with my remote, smart remote control. Plug one end into the USB 2.0. And the other end is micro. There's the micro 2.0. Now we have a little bit of shielding, but as you can see here, it's a bit dodgy. It looks on and off. Well, this is a USB 2. As you can see, the D minus and D plus have lit up. So that tells me this is okay for data. Let me get another cable. Right, I've got this cable now. It is this Momen, made in China. Basically, it's just a fancy cable that just lights up when you're charging. And it's also a micro USB. So let's plug it in and see what happens. Okay, it's a USB 2.0 cable. See the D minus and D plus. And it has a little button here, but it doesn't do anything. Interestingly, the shield button doesn't come on. So it's got no shielding, and it doesn't light up because there's no current passing through it. On to the next cable. Now onto the USB-C cable. Here we go. A type A and then a USB-C connector here. So let's plug it in here. Plug one end into the USB-C. And there we go. We've got a lot more lights lit up this time. We've got the ground, we've got the VBUS, which is the power data. We've got two V-buses lit up now. So, just going to supply a bit more current, but it appears to be USB 2.0 for data transmission. What would happen if I plugged it into the USB-C? A USB 3.0. And USB 3.0, not much change either. Okay, let's try another cable. Next up, I have a similar cable, also came with the different hard drive enclosure. USB 3.0 to USB-C. What's it gonna do? Shield comes on, if you can see. Oh, and we have more lights this time. We have RX1, RXTX is lit up as before, grounds. We've got the VBUS for the power. But look, we have D minus and D plus are lit up as well. So this is actually a better cable than the last one. And we also have shielding. That's interesting to know. Let's put this on the end and see what happens if we go from type A to USB C on both ends. Remember that. There we go. It appears not a lot has changed. The connector conversion worked perfectly. Okay, on to the next cable. Next up is this one here. It's purple. Purple on both ends. So, I don't even remember what this is. There's no markings on it or anything. So let's try the USB-C. USB 3.0 one at the top. And the USB-C one here. And as we can see here, it's only USB 2.0 standard, so it's not very fast at all, because we've only got D minus and D plus on the top. Other than that, we've got ground and power. Not a very fast cable. Next up, I bought this, which I usually use on a train when I'm out and about. So I'm only expecting the powers. I don't expect datas to be enabled, because it's four-way. We've got lightning and C, and well, that's micro as well, micro USB. Okay. Let's try USB-C. Oh, look at that, that's surprising. We have data. I was not expecting data on this cable. I only thought it would get power, but we've got the VBUS, which is the powers. And it's the USB 2.0, it says. And let's try the lightning connector. Well, look at that. Don't know too much about lightning connectors, but we appear to have 3D pins connected, ground and VBUS, which is power and ground, obviously. And let's try the micro connector here. Yep, USB 2.0 standard. Overall, better than expected. On to the next cable. Next up is this USB 4.0 cable, the daddy of data transfers at 40 gigabits. 240 watts, and it's got an eMarker chip inside it, made in China. Okay, I'll open this up and I'll continue. Here it is, and it's a beast. It's quite girthy as well, this cable. Here, look, USB 4.0, 40 gigabits, e-chip inside, USB-C on both ends. What's it going to do? Let's have a look. One end goes in here, the other end in here, and check that out. all the LEDs are lit up. I think what determines the speed is that they have a chip inside them that gets up to 40 gigabits inside the housing here. But this is certainly the best one I've seen so far. And let's plug it in the other end, see what happens if we invert them. Of course, it doesn't light up because there's no power going to it. Just continuity. Time to build the case. Right, that about wraps it up for this review. Overall, quite a nice device. What can I say, it's pretty small. It could be built better, but what do you expect for $16? Very functional with so many connections available to it. It's fairly easy to work out once you've plugged a few USB cables in. It becomes quite logical, basically. The grounds are the grounds, which are at the tops. And the V-bus is the power. The most basic element for it to function. And then we've got the D minus and D plus, that's for the USB 2.0 stuff, pretty straightforward. And then for more data, you've got the T axis and the R axis. You've got two of them, there and there, so that'll give you USB 3.0 speeds. And then aside from that, you've got the CC1 and the CC2s that allows it to choose the voltages. And then you've just got the SBU. That is basically for auxiliary stuff like audio channels and other fancy stuff like that. Not a bad device, very good. I can recommend it. Anyway, that about wraps it up for this review. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you in the next video. Cheerio for now.